Hi, my name's Alex Hutchinson, creative director on Far Cry 4. It's an open-world action-adventure shooter where we allow people to explore a fully realized Karat, which is kind of like a version of Nepal and the Himalayas, ride elephants, shoot guns, drive vehicles, and have a crazy time, and this time with your best friend. You've got to let me know. So this time around in Far Cry, we're looking for a really exotic location, somewhere that gamers hadn't been before. We're very lucky in that we're not a military shooter, so we like to tell unusual stories in unusual locations. We're looking for somewhere that had a lot of animals, especially elephants. Our game director, Pat Mete, was very excited by the idea of riding weaponized elephants. So we settled on a version of Nepal that we're calling Karat. It has a lot more verticality than previous games, a lot more cliffs, a lot more mountaintops, which was great because it also allows us to build new tools. So we have a grapple that you can pull yourself up a cliff. We have a helicopter that you can fly around. And of course, all of that's available for both players in co-op. Really, we want the player and the character they're inhabiting to be the same thing. So we want to get the protagonist out of the way, which means we spend a lot of time on our antagonists, on our bad guys. Vaas was a big hit in Far Cry 3, so we wanted someone unique and fresh for Far Cry 4. So you can probably see behind me, but Pagan Min is our new antagonist. And it's not just about having someone who hates you or wants to kill you or your family, as in many games. We wanted someone who was going to get a different reaction from players. So Pagan Min, and I don't think it's much of a spoiler to say he's absolutely not your father, but he does have a relationship with you and your family and a history there. And we like that uncomfortable introduction to the game where he basically invites you onto his helicopter, tells you you're going to tear shit up, which we think was pretty much the reason most people bought the game. So if we can get you feeling uncomfortable about the invitation from the villain, then we've got a great start to the game. When we first started the project, we were looking at different ways to expand the tool set in the game. Far Cry is often about creating your own story and overcoming problems in your own way. And we realized the best way to give the player more things to do was actually to put an entire other player in the environment. So you have access to all the animals, all the weapons, all the vehicles, and now so does your best friend. So basically, when you invite your buddy into the game, all those single player missions will be put on hold, giving you free access to all of the other activities, all the quests, the bell towers, the outposts, the fortresses, which you can conquer. And then when your buddy leaves, all that progress is saved and you go right back into your single player game. And of course, all the content is always available to the single player if you don't want to play with other people. This time around, you'll see a lot more work on foliage. You know, some of the trees actually have individually modeled leaves that are physics-based, so you get a crazy sort of realistic effect in the foliage. There's a new lighting system, so we're improving our work on nights, and a new fur system as well. So when you get right up close to those animals you're hunting, you should be able to see each individual hair on their back. So we really hope you're as excited as we are. Far Cry 4 is coming out this November on basically every platform you could possibly own, whether it's PC, Xbox One, PS4, PS3, or Xbox 360. Should I stay or should I go now? Should I stay?